What's going on, agents? Biz here with another Division 2 video. Today, we're going to talk about specializations, the foundation to any great build. We'll go over what these specializations are all about, how to unlock them, and where they land in terms of overall value to you and your agent. As always, if you're new here, maybe you're coming from Division 1 and you're wondering where your tactical link went, that's all good. You are welcome here. This channel is in the business of getting better together, and if you're about that, well, then this channel is for you. While we're on the topic of you, let me know what specialization is your favorite to create builds off of in the comments below. And while you chew on that, let's strap up, crack an ice cold liquid death, and get to it. Okay, wasting no time, let's dive into specializations. These tools fit into the lore right at endgame. As you can tell, things are still not okay in DC, as the Black Tusk have arrived to seize a moment of opportunity in the chaos of DC trying to get back on their feet. It's at this point that our quartermaster, Coop Dennison, who has been doling out skills that fit on our backpack really well, realizes that in order for our agents to fight this new threat, we gotta get bigger tools. Insert some really foreboding animation and boom, you're in endgame with a new signature weapon and specialization. Your agent will start out with three of these specializations to choose from, and those are Demolitionist, Survivalist, or Sharpshooter. Each specialization has its own tree that is unlocked by collecting specialization points. You can get these points a couple different ways, but keep in mind, you must have that specialization equipped to earn points for it. One way to get those specialization points is by completing the invaded missions for the week. Now, these invaded missions are a fresh take on that main mission, only with Black Tusk up to no good instead of Hyenas, Outcasts, or True Sons. Complete these with your specialization equipped, and you get 5 specialization points. The other way is just to play the game with the specialization equipped. Each watch level will give you 3 specialization points until you cap out at a max of 165 per specialization. Sounds like a lot, but honestly, easy peasy. Now, you might be looking at my screen and saying, Biz, you have 6 specializations. When do I get those other 3? Well, you can do that one of 2 ways. The easy way is to buy the year 1 bundle. Doing this will grant you those specializations instantly, along with some other neat stuff. The other way to unlock the year 1 specializations is to do your field research. Each of the 3 additional specializations, Gunner, Technician, and Firewall, have 5 levels of field research to complete. Each level grants you additional rewards and blueprints, and once completed, the specialization is unlocked for your use. So now that we know what these specializations are, let's dive into why you need to equip the right one to make a build work. If you've been around my channel, you've heard all of my builds kicked off at the specialization. The reason I start there is because unlike Division 1's tactical links that were more or less an ultimate, these specialization trees have passive talents, regular talents, exclusive skills, grenades, weapon mods, and armor kits that will create a foundation for any build. A great example of this is the Firewall Striker Shield. And this shield is an upgraded version of the Crusader Shield, and while yes, you could use the Crusader Shield and it might work, when you build with Firewall, that Striker Shield will grant an additional damage to targets that are within range of your shield. Those allies behind you and your shield, they also get that buff, which is awesome. So yeah, super important to have the right specialization on. How though, as a new or returning player, will I know which one's best? Well, I did the homework for you, so hold on to your seats as I took everything each specialization has to offer, and I'm going to give you my countdown for which specialization I think is the best. Now, before I get dragged into the comments for using terms like best and I think, keep in mind, this is my list. If you have input, totally cool. Just do it in a constructive manner. We're all here to get better together. To kick this off, we go to the bottom of my pile with the Survivalist. Now, this one comes with the crossbow as its signature weapon. Starting in the bottom right of the tree, we have a bunch of weapon icons. This will be similar to all the specializations, as you can choose which weapon you want to add weapon damage to up to 15% to 3 different weapon classes. You also get an exclusive weapon attachment by unlocking the weapon damage of a certain weapon class, and here we get a mag for 5.56 ARs that improves optimal range. Not the best. Moving over to the other talents, we get a tactical link that will grant 10% bonus damage to status affected targets, a bonus of skill haste when in cover, and ammo per second when doing a cover-to-cover move. Shifting up to the skills, we have a Healing Seeker Mine that can be unlocked. Speaking of skills, we should also mention a grenade is an incendiary grenade, dealing fire damage, which honestly isn't that bad. Rounding the specialization out, you have passive talents to outgoing healing, protection from elites, and a medkit that heals you and allies within 20 meters over 5 seconds to full health. So yeah, this one made the bottom slot for me, as the only two things I find of value here are the medkit and the signature weapon. If I didn't need that crossbow to make things easier at the end of dark hours, I might not even remember that it exists. I'll link a video to that drone killer build above and how to use it as well. Moving on to number 5, we have the minigun-wielding gunner specialization. Now, I know, I've been pretty high on this lately, but let's take a peek and see why this specialization isn't higher on my list. Looking at weapon upgrades, we do get a large ammo pouch for LMGs that will grant an extra 50 rounds. And while, yeah, that may sound awesome, it's only for belt-fed LMGs, so not so great. Heading over to talents, you do get 10% of your ammo back every 60 seconds, and your allies get 5% back. Very helpful if running Pistolero is a world modifier, and you start out with nothing but a pistol. You also get an extra 10% weapon handling while not moving, and a 5% rate of fire buff when you kill an enemy. For skills and grenades, this specialization is all about immobilizing your opponent with a Banshee Pulse and the Riot Foam grenade. Banshee Pulse will apply Confuse to anyone caught in its effect radius, and Riot Foam will apply Ensnare to anyone caught in the grenade radius. Both of these are very handy tools for sure. Heading up to passive talents, we get 10% armor on kill and a 50% faster reload on every third reload. Your medkit is also going to grant 30% armor as bonus armor for 10 seconds. So, in looking at this, I can see why this landed as low as it did in my rankings. Aside from the grenade and skill, this specialization isn't as helpful as some of the ones to come up the list. If I were to use a specialization, though, I'd do so with Hunter's Fury in a build like the one that I'm going to put on the screen. I didn't make a video for this one because Rogue Gold made this and I really dug it, but if you'd like to see more in depth, let me know. I'll make it happen. Or also check out Rogue Gold's video. Arriving at number 4, we have the Technician specialization. And here's where I might get chewed out, but listen up and you might learn something. Starting at the weapon attachments, we have a linked laser that's unlocked when you upgrade rifle damage. And this laser can attach to anything with a long rail, so most rifles, ARs, shotguns, some SMGs can receive this benefit. And its benefit is that anything aimed at gets pulsed. And that's very nice. Honestly, it's one of the best attachments that are out there. So how did this not make the top spot? Well, the further down the specialization you get, the less use I got out of it personally. Unless you're running a pure skill build, the link laser only gets you so far. Looking at the talents, we get a bonus to either skill damage or healing. The only specialization that actually gives you that option, by the way. Some bonus armor also when aiming a skill. And our team members who are near our skill become immune to shock and disorient. Nothing to call home about there, though. This specialization also loses some steam in the skills and grenades department, where we get a hive that buffs skills, but then a grenade that only does EMP damage, which is very situational. We pick up a little in the passive talents, where we get an extra skill tier that, to be fair, is really nice, especially with the introduction of Brazos and that two-piece extra skill tier there, too. We go back down, though, with the medkit, as it only heals you and your skills within 10 meters of you. Most of the time, my skills are long gone and far into the battle, so that healing isn't going to do much for them, so it's just a basic medkit. Don't get it twisted, and if you're dragging me in the comments, just hold off on your keyboard for a sec, because I'm still very high on the Technician. My main PvP build is set up on a Technician right now. Yeah, that's right, I said it. I'm back in the DZ, and I have this specialization to thank. I have this build on screen now, and if you want to see a full breakdown, well, you're probably going to get that really soon, just saying. So coming into the top 3, we start with a specialization I just started using and I'm very high on, and that's the sharpshooter. Weapon attachments, we kick it off with another one gifted from upgrading rifles, and that is a digital zoom scope. This attachment will be usable on anything with a longer top rail and will grant an additional 45% headshot damage and also reduces our crit hit damage by 5%. So a little trade-off there. Moving into the talents, you give your team an extra 10% headshot damage when they're closer to the enemy than you. Also, you get extra armor and rifle ammo when in cover. Next at the skills and grenades, you have the Tactician drone that pulses anything in a 50-meter diameter. And this is nice because you can get multiple pulses out of the drone instead of one pulse every few seconds from the standard pulse. Also, you're going to get a flashbang grenade that will apply blind to those caught in its massive area of effect. I think actually this grenade has the largest diameter out of all the grenades in the game, which is pretty awesome, and that blind really immobilizes people for sure. When we get to passive talents, you get a bonus to headshot damage when using a sniper or regular rifle, and you also get a 15% bonus to stability and snap to targets. Huge win for me, as I am a serial potato aimer. This is great. I'm stable now. I set this up on an all-red glass cannon vigilance damage build that's on screen right now. Very original, I know. But part of why the specialization landed here is because this setup is the most fun I've had in a while with this game. That stability makes getting headshots so satisfying. We have two left, and coming in hot at number two is the Demolitionist. I'm going to say it here, the top three was a hard choice, but for me, this one, no question, had to be in the mix. I use the specialization so freaking much in the raids, in PvP, in PvE, at the base of operations. It's the most consistently good specialization, in my opinion, and a great place to start out if you're just starting out with a Division 2. Use this one. Kicking things off at weapons, we get a tactical laser when the SMGs are upgraded, granting an extra bonus to crit hit chance. Now, if this was damage, that would be a lot better just because SMGs already have a lot of chance, but I'll take the extra chance somewhere else because I can put that on any sort of AR I want. Pretty cool. Moving into the talents, we get a bonus to targets outside of cover for your whole team, and we love that. Even more so, when you get to zero armor with this specialization, your equipped weapon gets a reload. So imagine you having a shotgun, getting to zero, getting unbreakable, and then getting all your shotgun back. If that's not enough, you can ignore explosion every 60 seconds with specialization. That is just so useful. So that's a pretty stacked talent pool, if I gotta say so. And moving into skills, we get a really great addition with the mortar turret. Now this little guy can be the best time or the worst, depending on what side of it you're on. You also get a frag grenade that applies bleed. That's not as cool, but I mean, it's still useful. This specialization could have taken the top spot if it weren't for the passive talents and the armor kit. Getting extra explosive damage and only 20% burn resistance is slightly underwhelming. Also, the armor kit bonus of 15 seconds with weapon handling, it's not as noticeable as the armor kit from a number one spot. Now don't get twisted, Demolition is still very high on my list. I literally use it in every raid I do because mortars hurt, unless you can ignore them. I'll link an older video to my do-it-all raid build so you can check it out. Please do. And maybe hit a like and subscribe on it if you want. Finally, what you all came for, and you guessed it at number one, we have Firewall. Now again, this is number one to me. Everyone's got opinions, so feel free to sound off constructively below. I just want to say in defense of this call, I don't think any other specialization's got a "you can't do that in PvP" nerf. So what makes this so good? Well, starting off at weapon attachments, you get a short grip when you upgrade your shotguns. And that short grip grants an extra 10% crit damage. And that's a whole lot of crit. Getting into talents, you and your allies will get bonus damage to enemies that are close to you. Also, you'll apply a burn on armor break to enemies within 5 meters of you. Now, this was disabled in PvP, so just an FYI, if you go into PvP and you're like, why is this guy not burning? That's why. That's the you can't do it in PvP nerf. Heading up to skills, you get a striker shield. Now, I know shields got nerfed. This shield's damage bonus is still very helpful, especially if you run 3 or more blue cores. You can still manage to drop the shield prior to breaking it, and that's important because if it breaks, you do get the confuse applied to you and your agent for just a little bit. While we're on skills, let's look at the grenades, and we get a cluster grenade with a firewall specialization. And this little guy breaks off into 6 clusters, doing a greater area of effect than most grenades. Still not as big as the flashbang, but still pretty big. Moving into the passive talents, you get the only meh part of the specialization, and that's health on kill, because who really looks at health? You also get a bonus to burn duration, which is great, because your signature weapon, it's a flamethrower. The thing burns for real. My favorite part of this specialization, though, is the med kit. The firewall med kit will allow your agent to get back 200% armor and 200% health back for 10 seconds. That amount of regen is absolutely nuts, and why this is my number one specialization. I'll link the build I'm showing on screen as well, in case you want to try a setup outheals unbreakable. Oh, did I say it? Oh no, yeah, something outheals unbreakable. Oh, let me check my fourth monitor. Overall, specializations are an important part to end game, and if you use them wisely, they'll make your agent a little less killable, which is always nice. Either way, I'll wrap this up here. You made it so far in this video. This is actually my longest video ever. And there's no Raid Shadow Legends ads? That's impressive, but also bad for me because I don't monetize. But even more impressive is you liking what you saw. And if you did, please hit that like and subscribe so you never miss a Division 2 or Heartlands video. And I'll see you next time I'm looking at you. I'm Biz, and I'm out.